Hi and welcome. In this video, we are going to see how you can communicate your Ignition SCADA with any OPC US server. Okay, so you can also use Process OPC US Emulation Server, CAP Server, or Matrican OPC US Emulation Server, or any OPC US server you want to use. Okay, but for this video, for simulation purpose, we are going to use this Process OPC US Emulation Server. Okay. So in this video, we will see how you can communicate this OPC US emulation server with Ignition SCADA and how we can fetch the tags of OPC US emulation server and we can read in our Ignition. Okay. So first of all, we will go to our Ignition SCADA gateway homepage and then after we will go to config section to config our OPC UA server. Okay. So we will scroll down. And then we will go to OPC client. Here you have OPC connection. Okay, so we will go to OPC connection. As you can see here, Ignition OPC US server. So this is the inbuilt Ignition SCADA OPC US server for loopback functionality. So if you connect it with any device, then tag of that device will be fetched via this Ignition OPC US server. Okay. But now what we want to do is we want to communicate with any external OPC US server. So we will press this button, create new OPC connection, and then which kind of OPC connection we want to create. So right now we want to create OPC UA connection. So that is why we will tick on this OPC UA and then we will press next. Okay. And then after we have to enter the endpoint URL. So where you can find the endpoint URL from OPC US server. Okay, so we will go to our Process OPC US Emulation Server and then you can see connection address UA for TCP protocol opc.tcp:// desktop and some name. Okay, so this is our endpoint URL. So we will copy this endpoint URL and we will paste it here. Okay, and then we will press next. Okay, so this server we have to choose as a OPC UA server. Okay. This simulation server and then we have to press next and then you have to choose which kind of security policy and security mode you want to use with this connection. Okay, so whenever you create any OPC US server or whenever you are configuring any OPC US server, you have those functionality. Okay, so if you go to endpoint in Process OPC US emulation server, you can see the security available security modes here, none, sign, sign and encrypt. Okay, and you can see the available security policies here. Okay, so with which security mode and which security policies you want to connect with this server, you can choose here. But for our simplicity, we are going to use as a security policy none and security mode none. Okay, and then we will press next. After that, this is the some information about our OPC UA connection and we have to trust this certificate. So we have to choose this radio button, yes. And then after we have to press next and then we can press finish. Okay, now the default name is available here. You can modify the default name, Process Simulation Server. Okay, and you have to remove the password from here because we didn't created any user for our OPC UA simulation server. You can create a user from this option. Okay, you can add user and their password, so only specific user can log in and fetch the data from this OPC UA server. Okay, but right now this is very simple communication, so we don't need any username or any security. Okay, and then after we will press this button, create new OPC connection. Okay, so this is our Process Simulation Server. Type OPC UA, read only is false. Okay, so it is a bidirectional communication, read and write, and you can see the status is connected. Okay, now we will read some tags from this Process OPC UA simulation server. So we will again scroll down and then we will go to OPC Quick Client. And then you can see Ignition OPC UA server. And the second one we just have set up is Process OPC US Emulation Server. So we will expand it and then we will go to our simulation folder, and then you can see our tag counter, random, sawtooth, sinusoid, square and triangle. You can read values from here. Okay, you can see the updated values here. So you can see whenever I am pressing read button, the value is going to change. Okay, so you can read values from here also, and then you can go to designer launcher and you can create a tag here, and then you can draw some graphics here. Okay, so we will click on this icon, plus icon, for adding tags, and then we will go to browse devices. So our device we want to add, and tag from which device you want to add, you have to select here. So we want to add some tags from this process simulation server, and then from simulation items we want to add some tags. Okay, so just add it and then press OK. Okay, so now simulation folder is available here. You can rename this folder simulation from process server. Okay, if you expand this, you can see the counter value, random, sawtooth, sinusoid, square and triangle. Now if you want this value in a graphics, then you can just drag and drop, and you want a tank, then it's here. Okay, so this is how you can communicate with your external OPC UA server. It can be a process OPC UA simulation server, or CAP server, or maybe Matrican, or any OPC UA server. Okay, so in this video we have seen how you can communicate with OPC UA simulation server of process. Okay, if you want to see the communication of CAP server or Matrican, then you can comment us, we will post the video. Okay, and if you have any doubt in this video, then you can ask us in the comment section, or you can send a mail, or you can directly ask us on the Telegram. Okay, so we will see you in the next video. Till then, take care, goodbye, and thank you.